now to that IRS been brewing since last Friday. The agency never really had a lot of friends, but right now it's certainly making a lot of new enemies. As we told you earlier in the show, a report being released this week by an inspector general shows that the IRS intentionally targeted Tea Party organizations and other conservative groups, going so far as to flag organizations with the words Tea Party or Patriot in their names, or groups that listed education about the Bill of Rights in their objectives. We're learning that the House Ways and Means Committee will soon be holding a hearing as soon as Friday to try to figure out what happened. Jenny Beth Martin is co-founder of the Tea Party Patriots group, and she knows firsthand about this scandal. Her group has been waiting years to get a response out of the IRS about their request for a specific status. She joins me now. Jenny Beth, please explain what happened.
Well, we've filed for our 501c4 and our 501c3 status several years ago, and the IRS has been stringing us along for years. In 2009, it would take maybe 4 to 9 months to get approval for these statuses, and yet Tea Party groups, 912 groups, Patriot groups around the country have been waiting years now as the IRS continues to string us along.
How expensive and time-consuming was the process? I understand that they would ask you to respond to a number of questions and demands, and it would take a long time. Is that right?
Well, they sent a letter asking for all sorts of questions, including the names or the posts that were on our Facebook post, all the comments on it, emails that we had sent, names of senators and congressmen that our supporters around the country had spoken to. Some of the information was impossible for us to collect. We're a voluntarily affiliated organization. We don't even know everyone who's affiliated with us. And some of it just is really none of the IRS's business.
You heard Senator Franken earlier in the broadcast, and to play devil's advocate and to paraphrase what he said, obviously no particular ideology or partisan affiliation should be targeted at all. But there are legitimate questions about whether groups with a clear political agenda should get this special tax-exempt status. What is your argument for why your group should not have to pay taxes?
Well, with a 501c4 status, you're allowed to have an agenda. You're allowed to be concerned about issues. And that's what we've been concerned about. We stand up for fiscal responsibility, constitutionally limited government, and free markets. We've never even endorsed a candidate. And our primary focus has always been on legislative issues, the health care law, the debt ceiling, cap and trade, the overspending, the stimulus. Our issues are focused on the legislation before Congress, and that's what a 501c4 is for.
When you had conversations with these IRS agents, these IRS officials, did you ever discern any anti-Tea Party or anti-conservative bias, or was it just bureaucratic demands that just were never ending?
Well, you could tell from the questions that they were asking and the fact that there's so many Tea Party groups and 912 groups and Patriot groups around the country were getting them, that this was something very unusual that was happening system-wide to people who were applying for the status. And so I could tell that that was happening. And it's obvious that they were trying to make the process as difficult as possible. And they're still, to this day, stringing Tea Party Patriots along.
All right, Jenny Beth Martin with Tea Party Patriots, thanks for your time.
Thank you. The president